Next in line of our speakers is Ms. Sheetal Rakheja. She is IGBC Delhi Chapter Co-Chair. She is architect.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. And today, I would like to just share a few things with you, our journey through the green buildings and through architecture. And whatever my office contribution has been to India. And I think I see a lot of power here, a lot of energy here, and I'm sure you will play a vital role in continuing this journey and the goals that Dr. Jain has set for all of you. So we are all aware that India is changing. What we started with, green building, footprint, I mean, the built-up area was 25 billion square feet that was being built in India. And 2030, there'll be 100 billion square feet, which is going to be built. So there's a lot of potential to make this new built-up area, which is coming up, making it green. These are the mega trends for the growth in India. We have mega corridors coming up. We have smart cities developing. But is really India changing? And do you think that is there any country which is more innovative than us? No. I think we are the most innovative country in this world. We are super intelligent, super jugadu, super innovative. So with so much talent that we have, so much intelligence, if it is put in the right direction, imagine what all we can achieve. Currently, I would say, two decades, we went wrong somewhere, you know. We lacked that integration, we lacked the right direction. So now is the need. That 100 billion square feet that needs to be built has to be built in the right way. So I'll show you some case studies of what we have been doing, you know, which we feel makes a difference. So we've been designing few offices, few residential apartments, and the approach has always been an integrated design, where it's not that you design an architecture of the building and then you get MEP later. It's an integrated approach from day one. You are concerned about the energy consumption of the building, about the water consumption of the building, about the ecological footprint of the building. So we don't make a building in Delhi same as a building which is to be made in Mumbai or somewhere else. It has to be a climate responsive architecture. We have in-house, like, you know, what we do is we do energy simulations to understand what should be the shading system of the building, what is the sun direction, how we can get glare-free light inside, but at the same time shade the windows. So our buildings and, always strive to meet the business requirement with the environment responsibility, with the resource responsibility, as well as sensitive to the well-being of the occupants. And these buildings, the green buildings that have, you know, come up, they have demonstrated that there is energy savings, there is water saving, there is human comfort, all has been achieved. So there are a lot of examples right now, if you look at the green buildings that have come up all across India. So the first example is Green Boulevard, which is one of the largest LEED platinum buildings in the world, 10 largest LEED platinum buildings in the world, where, if you see this building, the developer actually wanted to make a tall rise structure, a single tall rise structure of glass. But for a Delhi climate, it is not effective. So what we did was that instead of one tall rise building, we created three separate buildings which would mutually shade each other. The inspiration was from our ancient architecture, how we used to build around courtyards, around small, small gullies where the buildings would shade each other and create much cooler environment. This project is actually featured in National Geographic. And normally, an office about 150 square feet, you would air condition by 1 ton of air conditioning. Here we achieved, way back in 2008, 800 square feet of built-up space being air conditioned by just 1 ton of air conditioning. And main contribution for that was just a very logical thinking, just that inspiration from how we used to build so many years back. Shading, window wall ratios, buildings shading each other. And then more than that, what we wanted to do also was connect people to nature. Because right now we are just making concrete jungles with no respect to nature whatsoever. But there are studies which show that, you know, your patients would heal better if they're in an environment which connects to nature. Students fare much better if they're connected to nature. Healing process is far better if you're connected. So we wanted to do that. So what we did was the ground floor space, which is the prime space, we convinced the developer that you make it stilted, you introduce nature there. So every day when you get off, you go to your office, you're not driving onto the porch and just going up to the building. You actually walk across. You walk across this complete stilted space before you can actually enter any of the buildings. So you take this atrium, you take the elevators and go up to your floor. So you walk through these spaces. And during the lunchtime, during the evening hours, it gives a beautiful social space because human beings are social animals, finally. You need to connect to each other. So these spaces actually are used as a stress-free breakout zones for the people, which is surrounded by water bodies, which is surrounded by greenery. So this is this project won a lot of awards because of the innovation, because it's not, I would say, it's not use any Italian marbles, it's not use any Western products, it's all very Indian. It's a simple paint building, but the intent, the soul of the building is truly green, where people actually enjoy their evenings, they enjoy being here, they enjoy working here, because they're connected not only to nature, they're connected to natural daylight, they're connected to ventilation, to the natural air. What Dr. Jain talked about, air, ventilation, sun, we have to be connected there. That's when, you know, it improves your overall psychology, your overall well-being. So these are the simulation studies. From day one, we could predict what should be the shading system so that you get glare-free light inside. So these are a few more images of the campus. This is a project SHUNYA, which was designed a couple of years back with the intent of making a house completely out of waste materials, having zero energy this house produces its own energy, and the amount of energy it produces is the equivalent or even more than what it really needs. So, even in terms of water, so our challenge was zero water, zero waste, and zero energy. So in terms of the materials that were used, this house that you see is made out of four waste old containers, which we put around a courtyard. Because again, the inspiration from Jaipur, Havelis, and you know, more of our composite climate, where buildings are designed around a courtyard. The courtyard is a light well. It's a social active space where people actually, it's an extension of your household. So if you see, if you have a courtyard, people would be sitting around there, there'll be ladies using that space. So it's a multifunction space which the courtyard actually performs. So we have a vegetable garden around it. And we have a solar panel above it. The energy consumption of this project is only 1.26 watts per square feet, as against our houses, which consume 8 to 10 watts per square feet. So the biggest challenge was reducing that energy consumption from 8 to 1.26 watts. And then that little energy that this house does need is through the solar panels. So how did we really achieve that? This just shows how the complete house is made out of waste materials. This is a courtyard and center, and the complete house revolves around that. So these are some pictures of all the waste materials, waste furniture, which was remodeled to be used within the house. I will just quickly go. So the same principle of the zero energy house we have used in this project coming up in Kolkata, which is using only solar panels to power the complete office. So that's the main office. The complete building facade is made out of solar panels. So first we reduce the energy consumption of this office by balancing the window wall ratios, giving insulated facade, insulated roof, And then little energy it needed is through the solar panels again. So on the south side, we've placed the cabins, which have, you know, which have these tilted south-facing solar panels, and still they achieve good views outside. So all in all, these are the targets which we had set for the office, and we achieved. We reduced the energy consumption to about 40%. We gave the best indoor air quality. 90% of the occupied spaces got glare-free light. We had much better environmental footprint, and we used all sustainable materials. In the end, I would like to say that, you know, sustainable infrastructure facilitates a place or a region towards the goals of sustainable living. And that will help to make better sustainable communities, which all of us can be very proud of. I envision India as a society with zero energy bills, zero waste, zero water, and all that is really possible. We've showed it with SHUNYA. We're carrying on the tradition with more buildings which are now more net positive. We envision India as a minimal carbon footprint, an earth-friendly society, a net positive India. We envision SHUNYA. And this shlok is very important, and it means a lot. It means for the prosperity, for harmony, and for peace for everyone, not for your own self only. Thank you so much.